Here on the plains of East Africa, a technological revolution is underway. In 2018, the number of people accessing the internet pushed past 4 billion. People, businesses, and devices have moved into a permanent state of hyperconnectivity. The way we go online to trade, work, travel, even socialise has given rise to the digital economy. Southeast Asia is now the world's third largest region for internet users, with more people online than the entire population of the US.
And here in Vietnam, more than half the population is now connected to the internet, allowing this former war-torn country to flourish in the new digital economy.
But many regions of the world still struggle to gain access to the internet. In East Africa, getting online is still largely out of reach for most people, and this is stagnating economic development. However, the tide is turning. In Tanzania, a team of international engineers, led by Vietnam, are building a state-of-the-art fiber-optic telecommunications network. When complete, it could help revolutionize the economy of one of the poorest countries on Earth. I'm Dr. Jordan Nguyen. I'm an engineer and an inventor. And I'm driven by understanding the intersection between technology and humanity. So let me take you on a journey to show you how Vietnam is assisting Tanzania to redefine Tanzania's relationship with the world.
One internet user at a time.
This is Vietnam connecting East Africa. East Africa. Home to Mount Kilimanjaro and a vast savanna. A thousand different species of wildlife call this place home, including the largest living land mammal, the African elephant. It's also home to 20 African territories with a total population of over 500 million. And it's one of the fastest growing economic regions in the world. But despite many achievements of the last few decades, much of East Africa still falls behind when it comes to both internet access and reliable mobile phone coverage. This has dragged down economic development for years.
You will see that the level of development is still very low. Level of illiteracy is also low. The access to rural areas are very difficult still. This puts a challenge for the development of these areas.
Here in Mozambique, outside of the city centres, internet and mobile phone connectivity is almost non-existent. For Mike and the rangers of Nyasa National Reserve, this poses a life-threatening problem.
This is a gun, but it's a man-made. People are doing this, and they used to shoot this. They do everything, they put everything which is needed, and they used to shoot. They use AK-47, they use 375. The problem is if we go very far than 50 kilometers south or north, we don't have any network. Then it's a problem because we don't have any communication.
Since the 1970s, almost 70% of the wildlife here in Mozambique has been lost, mainly due to poaching.
In December, we'll fight with people, which we recovered 24 ivory. In January on 10th, I'll fight with people with a cap AK-47. That's a big problem because they use poaching with guns.
Without mobile communication, it makes it very difficult to outsmart the poachers. But a newly installed mobile telecommunications network has become a game changer.
A 1 kilometer. Podemos ir.
Para nós sairmos de.
Once a poacher is spotted, a simple phone call is made to mobilize remote teams.
Fica aqui atrás dele.
Há uma coisa que está em frente às carcaças de elefante assim. Nós estamos a apontar para lá.
It's amazing how something as simple as making a mobile phone call can help to revolutionize the fight against animal poaching for Mike and his team. But state-of-the-art telecommunications is not only being used as a weapon against poaching, it's helping the country to gain increased access to the global digital economy. Inspired by Mozambique's success story, in neighboring Tanzania, work starts on the building of its own state-of-the-art fibre optic network. It is the biggest telecommunications project in East Africa, involving an international team led by Vietnam. Mr. Huan has travelled from Vietnam to Tanzania to oversee the project on the ground. He faces enormous challenges.
Khó khăn thứ nhất là về địa lý ở đây ấy, thì đất nước Tanzania rất rộng, đường rất dài. Nên do vậy là cái khối lượng thi công nó lớn. Khó khăn thứ hai là dân cư ở rất thưa. Để đảm bảo được cái số lượng người triển khai đào cáp ở đây ấy, thì nhiều khi là rất nhiều tuyến là phải chở từ nơi khác, có khi hàng trăm km đến.
Tanzania is about twice the size of France. That's a lot of ground to cover. The Maasai people have lived in these lands for hundreds of years and know how vast this country can be.
The life is so complicated in Maasai. As you see, the houses we are living in, not so good, and the water is so far.
Tanzania is a very big country, so there is most of areas which are very remoteness. So you can get there, there is no network, there is problem, and how to get the communication is a big problem. In most of area, especially remoteness areas.
18,000 kilometers of fiber optic cables are being laid across almost 5,000 kilometers of land. And 2,500 base stations are being built at the same time. The added challenge is how this project is being driven by an overseas telecommunications company over 8,000 kilometres away in Hanoi, the capital of Vietnam. It's hard to believe that just 30 years ago, Vietnam, along with Tanzania, were some of the poorest countries in the world. Up until the 1980s, most of the population of both countries lived in severe poverty. Many years of war-torn conflict and European colonization in the 20th century had devastating effects on both countries. But while both Vietnam and Tanzania fought hard to recover, today Tanzania still remains largely disconnected from the internet. This is stagnating economic development. Vietnam, however, has gained a reputation for being one of the fastest growing economies in the world. An increasing internet penetration rate has played a crucial role in the recent success of Vietnam's economy.
I think from 2000, GDP in Vietnam goes very fast, yeah, compared with the time before. Yeah. I think a lot because of telecom infrastructure in Vietnam become advanced, become good. Internet and telecom in Vietnam contribute at least around 2-3% of the GDP.
Inspired by Vietnam's success, this is what Tanzania is hoping to emulate. Connecting a country the size of Tanzania to the internet comes with enormous challenges. Challenges that Vietnam has faced before and managed to overcome. Today, engineers are ensuring the fiber optic cables are buried deep and as straight as possible. This ensures a direct path for the light signals that will pass through the cables.
As the cables are being laid, construction is well underway on the mobile base stations. Extending as high as 50 metres, they will eventually transmit the mobile phone signals in unison across Tanzania's vast landmass.
Another thing Vietnam and Tanzania have in common is the weather. Both countries lie in the tropics, bringing huge amounts of rain during the monsoon seasons.
For the animals of the savannah, this is a welcome break from the searing heat. For the project team, this brings a frustrating delay.
Về thời tiết đấy thì Tanzania là tháng 11 là vào mùa mưa thứ hai. Còn cái mục tiêu về khai trương ấy thì chúng ta mục tiêu khai trương vào tháng 10. Nên do vậy là cả hai cái mục tiêu này đều gây áp lực rất lớn về vấn đề triển khai xây dựng từng mớ lưới về Tanzania.
Meanwhile, a vision of Tanzania's connected future can already be seen across the border in neighbouring Mozambique. Viettel completed the installation of a fibre optic network here in 2012.
To come from centre to here, I take 30 minutes. I'm talking about 25 kilometres or 30 kilometres. So I take 30 minutes also to be here.
Lionel has the job of ensuring remote communities have access to top-up cards and cheap mobile phone units.
This place, as you can see, is a place very poor. But they are good people. They are very clever. They don't have electric power, but they find a way to charge their phones, to listen to the radio. I have special customers. There are some customers I can trust. I can supply products to him. And next time when I go there, I collect money. I give them by credit.
An average mobile telephone costs about $100. People can choose to pay in installments to make the purchase more affordable.
Because of selling these cards, I'm saying that I've increased my business up to 10%. Nowadays, we have very good communication. We are using this this network anytime we want, night and day, every time we are using this easily.
Over the last 5 years, Mozambique has seen a slow but steady growth in internet usage, with almost 8% of the country now online. Back in Tanzania, engineers are now days away from completion.
When I say stop, we just stop, okay? Okay. Yes. Go, 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 guys. Na hiyo. Kama unaweza, haiwezi kuja.
Hôm nay chúng tôi ở đây thực hiện lắp đặt thiết bị phục vụ cho dịch vụ 2G và 3G, thiết bị thu phát sóng.
The last base station has been installed, and over 18,000 kilometres of fibre optic cable now lies deep underground.
So you roll that cable, okay? Normally push it. Otherwise, we can start to roll this cable, okay?
The entire network has been completed within just 8 months.
What is our aim is to transform the telecommunication service into a basic service, into a service that is not a luxury, because it can make a difference in the life of the people. And of course, people need it. People need it to communicate with the family. People need it to know about what is going on in the world.
By October of 2015, the network is ready to be switched on for the very first time.
So support from the government of Tanzania go with the e-government program, support for school, student, teacher with the online education program.
Yes, I strongly believe that the poor people never poor forever. If we can help them from the beginning, yeah. When they have the telephone, they have the more connection, they have more information, they can do business, they can send their product high price. So it means that step by step becoming richer.
Now we already built a very good telecom network in Tanzania, and I think we make Tanzania now some kind of very high level of telecom technology.
Newly improved access to the internet also has a big impact on education. Often the high price of books and teaching materials are too expensive for students to buy, but this could now be a thing of the past.
For myself as a teacher, it is my pleasure to have this because many times I use to walk a distance from here to Chalinze, about 30 kilometers, for searching internet, at least for searching internet for the purpose of having some material.
Very happy today to get this access, to get these books, which were very expensive. To a normal son of peasant like me, that I can afford to buy it. So I'm very happy today, and my dream of being a doctor is coming true.
Meanwhile, across the border in nearby Mozambique,
we believe that by contributing on education, we are contributing for the development of the country for the next generation. Because with that, we believe that children will have access to different contents, will have access to different realities.
And improved mobile phone coverage is now closing the gap between cities like Dar es Salaam and rural communities.
Hii sasa hivi na maliza kama miezi nane hivi tangu ulivyoingia kwa hapa sokoni kwetu soko la samaki feli. Na nashukuru Mwenyezi Mungu kwa mtandao wa Halotel. Kila siku zinavyozidi kuendelea ndio jinsi tunavyokubali. Naona kutokana na mara nyingi tunapiga simu za nje ya Dar es Salaam. Kwa hiyo simu za nje ya Dar es Salaam mara nyingi yani ukiwa na Halotel
network available, so at any time, even nowadays in mountainous areas, you can get many communication very well.
For the people of Tanzania, the next challenge will be improving digital literacy skills and training local entrepreneurs to harness the power of tapping into the digital economy. With access to the digital economy comes the arrival of digital platforms, platforms which can become businesses in their own right.
Digital economy grows based on intellectual capital, not based on natural resources or even financial resources like in traditional economy.
We are trying to show people that telecommunications can be more than just telecommunication, more than voice, more than just internet. And when we use the ICT, we can apply it to the different sectors of the economy. We can apply it to the health, we can apply it to the education sector, we can apply it to the commerce.
For example, in Kenya, the M-Pesa mobile money transfer service was launched in 2007 and now exists in 10 countries. It has lifted 2% of Kenyans out of extreme poverty by giving people access to mobile money services. Tanzania's rapidly improving connectivity sees the country join a community of other emerging economies from around the world, all benefiting from Vietnam's digital outreach from South America to Africa to Southeast Asia. The control center here in Hanoi employs a team who monitor the running of all networks that Viettel have invested in across the globe, reaching over 100 million people, all gaining better access to the global digital economy, with Tanzania being the latest.
Innovation is dream. If you have a dream, So you can do almost anything.
The job of connecting Tanzania is not only a story about poverty alleviation, but it's also a story about the economic kinship of two very diverse countries, forged through their persistence to overcome a troubled past and to reshape the future.